Hola, buenas. A nombre de la Junta de Directores del Consorcio de GET, se dan la más cordial bienvenida al 2024 Best Practices Showcase to Celebrate Technology Innovation for Hispanic Success in Higher Education. Mi nombre es Reina y estaré a cargo de presentar a los oradores de las sesiones concurrentes de este salón. Antes de comenzar, quisiéramos solicitar su apoyo por lo siguiente. Primero que todo, esta presentación será en español. Va a haber una interpretación simultánea sucediendo, para eso necesitaría los headsets, quien los necesite podría puede ofrecer mi compañero, estaría pendiente a eso. Favor de poner su celular en silencio para que puedan prestar toda su atención a esta presentación y evitar cualquier interrupción. Y por último, nuestro personal pasará un QR code a todos los participantes para que puedan completar la evaluación electrónica de esta sesión antes de salir de este salón. Igualmente, pueden ver en su credencial el QR code para acceder a la evaluación electrónica. Su insumo y su recomendación son muy importantes para nosotros. Ahora, estamos listos para comenzar. El título de esta presentación es Viajes Académicos y Programas de Intercambio de Experiencias Bilingües con Perspectivas que Enriquecen el Aprendizaje. Y vamos a recibir a los oradores Meli Fernández, Sofía Saldaña y Alberto Acevedo de EDP University. Muchísimas gracias.
Muy buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Sofía Saldaña. Yo les estaré presentando un reto de intercambios de EDP University a Southeast Missouri State University en febrero de 2022. A pesar de que no tuve el privilegio de participar de Chicago, una de las dos, digamos que tuve la oportunidad para vivir la experiencia académica en el campus universitario y convivir con personas de diferentes culturas. Quiero contar mi experiencia de semestre de la carrera de ENA.
Southeast Missouri State University.
It was an extraordinary
todo el semestre
académico.
Una de las experiencias más significativas fue mi primera experiencia en la Yo recuerdo que el tío estábamos con muchos sweetmates en el dorm y estábamos todos verificados
en la universidad
y nosotros decían no.
And they would tell us, no, it's just, no, you have to just wait. They say it's going to snow, but it doesn't. So Alicia, somebody said, it's snowing, Sofia. Yes, it's snowing. So we went to the room, so we got what the first one we found, and then we went at 2 a.m. to watch the snowfall. One
of the courses that I completed
was the ceramics. We recycled the material. We never waste the material. They taught us how to use different tools, how to use different chemicals, how to apply them, how not to apply them, and to the final process to obtain the final process.
Here,
as you can see,
we
completed the
training.
The one on the left was my first ceramics compared to the final work.
That was
it's one of the most gratifying experiences I had. I participated in the Southeast Series of the Art and Design Jury Series, where one of the pieces was to be exposed at the Kennedy Hall for perpetually. And also, I submitted a collage, a picture collage.
Another
course I took, a photography course.
This course gave me the
opportunity to find potential for most simple things, taking into consideration that makes photography unique. That was part of my project. The exhibit.
This was a piece
that the university bought. And this was the one that got a prize.
El cual me llevó a tener el Best in Show. Es el máximo reconocimiento de la exhibición de arte.
Y el semestre pasado, otra vez, It was very hard to focus on that.
Perfection so that you're loving yourself, finding your identity.
the bathrooms, as I said, it's an impression. It's not an design, possibly commercial way. So this taught me how to design a public domain that is a backstage. And then this portion takes what is fashion history, and be curious about, you know, it's summarizing different trends and time and chronology that were appropriate for each specific period. And basically, we were assigned plays and scripts and poems to analyze and to investigate more, and then design the costumes for the people. So this is my runway. I play called The Line of Europe, and it takes place in Europe during a few times. So many of the things that I remember in the play were real historical figures. Every time I had to do a search on each character, so it could be placed on the mindset of each of them. So understand them better. Then I was the size of each character using a lot of fabrics at the costume shop. And the ones we find on the sign, we make a list. Here's the list for each character that we have. We were each piece using the right value of the period. So we could call a play, for example. And this was the final project of my final project. We had to do a sign under the reflective. And something I loved about this course was that there were no limits on the creativity for each topic. So it was strange interpretation. The students are really interesting when you see the presentations of each project, to be able to visualize the different interpretations and different branches of art that could be incorporated into the topic. So for the final time, we did those prints made to scale and sheets, and the sheets were so I'm here and my work is still being spoken of there, and I feel very grateful for it. This work, since I was little, I've always loved art, and I've been drawing. However, there was a point in my life where I lost an essence, and getting there to take this course allowed me to connect with that inner me, and I have a certain time which you only can express emotions. Sometimes I feel that situations happen, and we don't allow ourselves to process things directly. And art is a good way to use those emotions to create something new, something beautiful. For example, that tote bag. I would say that that's my first design in the class. And then you can see it all. But all the time, that thought that the cards are for boys and dolls are for girls. I always wanted to play with the dolls, but I was allowed due to gender complex. So it's me creating this child and creating something beautiful. Thank you. which will process the way we will to stay grounded and focused during the civic series. And here, this is my friend, Chloe. Fashion marketing background, and the friend, I'm from Puerto Rico, and Fall Festival, here we get some happy, happy, we got better a lot, screening for our class, and we were able to make a great song, and then there's Chloe, and then over here I have thanks to the universe, I could connect with new souls and new people that, whether it's celebrating a birthday and then the last picture I have which I have screen printing, which I met through the app. Finally, one more day, drinking tea. I'm here, holding me. I'm going to make sure that I can see the model.
Any questions or doubts?
Sí, sí. Me interesa conocer un poco cuál fue la experiencia de ustedes en términos del lenguaje, cómo hicieron esa transición de estudiar aquí en español en
Venezuela. Between studying here in Spanish and then going for exchange program in another country. And also, how was the financial aspect? Because that's always a great issue. How do you manage? Because the universities here are more expensive. I'm bilingual. I'm fully bilingual. So. Since I know I've always spoken English very fluently. How many people tell me, are you really from Puerto Rico or are you from Spain? So in that respect, I really wasn't having difficulty. And financially, I had the chance to have a waiver for classes as such. I was offered that, so I didn't have to pay anything for the courses. But I didn't have to pay the dorm. And the food and all those things and all the other expenses that you have to pay for. You have to do the door, the trash bags, the detergents, all those little expenses. And also I'm going out, I'm going to share with people. So you have to pay for those expenses. So you have to really budget for all that. Did you take a loan? Yes, I did take a loan to be able to go there for the food and food on board. Because I didn't have to pay for the taxes. In my case, I'm also fully bilingual. However, when you get there, at first, you have to really get used to it because with your brain, it's used to Spanish. But it's part of that process when you're adjusting. And halfway, I was feeling like I was speaking English with every friend. And I'm here speaking more English. I also took a loan to cover the dorm, the payment plan, which always need to also take some extra money, some savings, because for you know, what do you learn how to manage? You can do it. Any other questions, comments? What was the most gratifying experience for each one of you? I can say getting to know all the cultures because you have students from different parts of the world in countries that you don't even know about. For example, I met you from Zimbabwe in Africa, I met people from Norway, from East Timor, which is a very small island on the other side of the world, Japan, Ukraine. So for me, I think it was what really created our most gratified, because as a class and a professor, I also create a great ties with professors from Rwanda, who was an essential person in that process for Alicia and for me. So meeting the different people who were there, the students, is the
nice.
So like Cambridge, I would say, the great exchange program helped me become more independent in many aspects. Also, it helped me to give me direction with respect to what's my next objective, my next goal, or what's the steps I should take to reach them. So I was more focused when I came back. And with the mindset that even though I'm not sure I'm going to achieve it, I'm going to set my mind on achieving it and doing it, making it happen. Did you have to ask, or do you want to come back, or mention something? We had, as we spoke, we worked together. And the adaptation process is very difficult. She was my roommate, so that, well, I was always in her. So to be able to be, if you're living with somebody you're not always, you know, that for the world percent, it's a little difficult. But for us, that was the biggest challenge I had. We also had,
como que
did when it was the year because
if you have any problems, let us know. We're happy. Thank you very much.